shorty, it's your birthday. We gon' party like it's your birthday. We gon' sip a Cardi like it's your birthday. And you know we don't give a fuck, cause that's your birthday.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I am super excited to have you here today and share this day with me. So if you haven't got it from the title yet, today is my birthday. An amazing soul was born today. A beautiful soul was born today, and that's me. I am turning 28 years of age, and for some reason I'm super excited about my birthday today. I rarely celebrate my birthday or even get excited about it, but this year for some reason, I don't know, I just feel so excited. I feel grown. I feel so mature, and I feel like, you know, I'm becoming like fully into a woman. And yeah, so because I'm turning 28 years, I decided to share with you guys 28 lessons I have learned in my 28 years of life. And I feel that these points are very valuable and it's worth it to share with you guys. If you're new here, hi, my name is Molly and today is my birthday, so you better subscribe. Like this video today. If you've never liked my video, today's the day you are supposed to like my video, just to give me love and, you know, drop me a comment down below and wish me a happy birthday. And yeah, let's get right into the video. So my first lessons I have learned so far is that God is always in control, regardless of your religion, regardless of your spiritual belief. I would love to think that you have something, or, you know, someone that you pray to and have faith in. So I would assume that's your God. I am a Christian and I believe that peace comes not from only talking to people or things, but talking to God, because from him we are comforted. And I always have this feeling that I know that my God is in control, because we know that God will always make a way where seems to be no way. He works in ways we cannot see. So yeah, always trust and believe in God, because he has your best interests at heart. My other point is that life is a journey and not a destination, because a lot of times in our lives we get too much focused on big dreams, big goals and big aspirations, and we forget to enjoy the process itself, which is life. So slow down sometimes, enjoy and spend time with your family, be present in the moment and enjoy this journey of life. My other point is that adulting is hard. You know, when we were all young and we could not wait to grow up, but nobody told us that growing up comes with so much responsibilities, builds upon builds upon builds. But you know what? We are all in this together. No one has anything figured out. We are all trying to live the best life we can. So don't take life too seriously. Just enjoy life. Whenever you're making mistakes, it's okay. Just enjoy this process called life, knowing that there are other people as well who are also trying to figure life out. So my other point is that it is okay to say no. Don't be scared to say no, worried about disappointing someone or losing someone. If you feel that something does not sit right with you or your values, or you feel that it's not okay, just say no. Saying no does not mean that you do not value or respect the other person. It's more like putting yourself first and being selfish with your time. Doing what makes you happy is necessary and not selfish. So don't just do things to please people. Say no whenever you feel that something is not right. And yeah, no one's gonna judge you for that, because it's your own personal decision. So make wise choices. My other point is that patience is a virtue and a key to success. For anything to happen in life, we have to be patient, because whenever we plant a seed of greatness, we have to be patient and give it time for it to grow. Great things take time, and we have to learn to give time for things to happen in our lives. Sometimes you may have to struggle a little bit or put in some effort or even a lot of effort, but you have to be patient and have a lot of drive for you to succeed in life and for you to see fruitful results. Because, you know, just because the process is not easy does not mean that the end results are not going to be beautiful. Always be patient, and yeah, success is coming your way, okay? My other point is that stop comparing your journey to others, because everyone has their own different path to walk in this life, different dreams, different goals, different aspirations, and plus God has laid out different destinies for each one of us. So live your journey and enjoy your journey, and stop comparing yourself to other people. I'm just sorry guys if you keep hearing buses passing around, because for some reason, I don't know, they know I'm filming and they're just trying to just keep moving around. So apologies if you hear the buses pass. My other point is that it is okay to make mistakes, because that's how we learn, through making mistakes and taking as much risk as possible in this journey of life. Our failures help us through our way to success, because every mistake that we have made is a lesson that we have learned. And also, never regret anything that has happened in your life, because you know what? You cannot change it, you cannot undo it, maybe you cannot even forget it. But you know what? Just take the lesson and move on. You are still going to make more mistakes in life, but you know what? Learning never stops. So keep making mistakes, because that's how you grow and that's how you learn. My other point is that life is short. This is very evident to what's happening around the world at the moment. Never take anything for granted, because oftentimes we don't appreciate what we have until it's gone, whether it's our health, our family, our friends, our careers, our money, or even job opportunities. And nothing is guaranteed to be there tomorrow, including the people that we love. This is an important life lesson, because things and life can change in an instant. So with that being said, just make the most of what you have today and appreciate whatever you have today while you still have it. My other point is that always be grateful for even the smallest milestones, because you know what? The power of gratitude attracts the happiness and abundance that you deserve in your life. I'm talking about even just being able to wake up in the morning, being able to breathe, being able to have food on your table. I'm not talking about buying your dream car or about building your dream house or going for that fancy vacation. No, I'm talking about the smallest things that are happening in your life at this point that are giving you comfort. And I always believe that gratitude brings riches and complaints brings poverty. So the more you are grateful to God for everything that you're having in your life, the more rich you become. And the more you complain, poverty is calling you. So always be grateful. Other point is that not everyone is going to like you, and that's fine. Just focus on the people that do. You don't need everyone to like you or even agree with you. And I know that it's human nature to want to belong or to want to be liked, respected, or even valued. But if it's at the expense of your integrity and happiness, then it's not worth it. Validation should only come from inside, and caring about what other people think is just a waste of time, because they haven't been in your shoes. They have no idea of the choices you've had to make in your life to be where you are today. So nobody cares what other people think. Just live your life and live your own true life. Another point is that love yourself, because you know what? No one else in this world is going to love you as much as you love yourself. Invest in self-development, pamper yourself, take care of yourself, be kind to yourself. If you want to buy that bag, buy it for yourself. If you want to take that trip, take it for yourself. Because you know what? A lot of times in our lives, we live with so much responsibilities and we forget to take care of ourselves, because responsibilities are always going to be there. Like, always going to be there. Your body is getting old. Sorry to say this, but your body is getting old. And the more you take care of your body, the more you age graceful. So keep taking care of yourself. Be kind to yourself. And be selfish if that's necessary, because why not? My other point is that never beg for love, time, or attention from anyone. Let those people that genuinely do care for you spend time with you, because no one in this world is ever busy. Like, if someone gives you an excuse that they were busy, no one is busy. It's all about priorities. So if someone considers you as a priority, then they're going to create time for you. Another point is that never settle for less than what you deserve. You are an amazing being who deserves the world. And if someone cannot see that or cannot give you that, then they're just not for you. And this applies either to relationships or even to careers. If you feel that you can bring more to the table than what people are offering you, just say no. It's okay. Like I said, it's okay to say no and just go for something that you feel you genuinely deserve. Other point is work hard, because hard work is the key to everything in life. Nothing works overnight. There are no shortcuts to success. And trust me, you're going to fail a couple of times, but you always have to get up and keep moving, because determination and persistence is also some of the keys to achieving great success. And a lot of people always want the fruits of having worked hard without even lifting a finger, but no, it doesn't work that way. Success requires investment of time, investment of energy, and your mind. And the fruits of your own labor are the sweetest. So hustle, guys. It's not easy. You have to actually put in the effort. Other point is that never stop trying, especially when it comes to chasing your dreams, because trust me, in the future you're going to look back and wish that you had given it maybe one more shot or just put in a little bit of effort. Because what's there to lose or what's there to regret? If you don't make it, at least you gave it a chance, and then you will be satisfied and content that I tried even though I didn't make it. And maybe you can give it one more shot and actually make it through. So never stop trying. Other point is choose your friends wisely. Oh, this is something that I always preach, and I'm going to try and make a video regarding the same. But always choose your friends wisely. You know, the friends who are always available to go out and have a good time, but whenever you try to reach out to them, whenever you are in need, they are of no help. Yeah, I'm talking about those people. Always be wise when it comes to friendship, because I think you'd rather have two good friends than have a bunch of friends who are never there for you when you need them, but just there for you to party and all. Be wise, because I feel like the more you grow and become an adult is the more you realize that you actually don't need a lot of friends in your life. Just a few, even maybe five is a lot. two, three good friends are enough. You don't need a whole bunch of friends to just take pictures and go out. You need people who are going to genuinely be there for you whenever you need them. So be wise. Also, don't forget to nurture the bonds that you have with your friends, because it's reciprocal. If you create good bonds with them, then they're also going to create good bonds with you. You know, the friends who become your sisters, yeah, those are the friends I'm talking about. The other point is that blood is thicker than water, right? But not all the time. I love my family a lot. Like, my family always comes first, and I know for a fact that whatever happens to me, if everyone else abandons me, my family is going to be there for me. I love them dearly. I have no idea where I would be without them. But truth be told is that there are people in life who would take a bullet for you, or a stranger who could be of more help to you than your family. So my point is that sometimes the people that you think are going to be there for you might not be, and that's okay. Don't have too much expectations with the, you know, with the cloud around family or friends, because sometimes the person who is going to get you out of trouble is actually not even related by blood to you. So just be open and just be accommodative to other people. I hope it makes sense. My other point is travel as much as you can. And before anyone comes for me, travel doesn't have to be international, and you don't have to be on an aircraft for you to travel. Explore your city, explore your country, because I'm sure there are so many places or so many things you can do. To be honest, traveling is one of the most enriching things I have done in my life, because it just opens up your eyes and gives you an understanding of how people live or how people behave and interact, and also exposes you to new cultures, new traditions, and new food. So yeah, that's actually the fun part about traveling, experiencing new food from different, you know, cultures. So don't be a stuck-up person, explore different things. Whenever you travel, actually, try to explore the cuisine of that place you are in, but don't do it in China, okay? I don't have a good experience trying Chinese food in the streets. It's, ugh, don't try it. I mean, I don't care how much you love Chinese food. China street food is, the smell, the look of things, it's just all so weird. I mean, I saw frogs, I saw very, very weird things, and I'm so traumatized from that. Ugh, it's just something else. Don't try it, okay? But yeah, travel is just, with traveling, you have memories that are going to live with you new forever and ever. So travel as much as you can. My other point is that you are your own competition, because there is no such thing as healthy competition. Competition only breeds jealousy and hatred, and it's just destructive, you know. The only time it's a healthy competition, it's when you are competing against yourself. My other point is that lighting another person's candle does not dim your own. What I mean by this is that help people whenever you can. If you know that you have a friend who's looking for a job and there is a vacancy in your company, why don't you share with your friend and just, you know, take in their CVs and forward them to the HR? Because if they get the job, it doesn't mean that you're going to be fired. It just means that you've helped them in their journey, and that's very kind. Nothing beats the power of kindness, and you actually get more when you give more. So yeah, being kind is more important than being right. So always being kind and always help other people grow whenever you can. Other point is that live your life, because life goes on so fast. Just the other day we were teenagers, and now we are already in our late 20s. It's like life moves on so fast and we have no idea. So just live your life to its full extent, because we only get one shot at life, and just make sure that you live your best life and enjoy it to the fullest. Other point is that always be yourself. People will love you for you. There is something very safe and very calming about genuine and authentic people, whether it's their character or their personality or even something simple as their accent. And yeah, I feel like a lot of people relate to genuine people. And if you can accept yourself and love yourself, then it's very easy for you to be yourself. A lot of people try to be fake just because they want to try to fit in into a certain community or situation. But the goal is not fitting in, but rather standing out. So get the point. Always try to stand out. Don't change yourself trying to fit in into anything, but rather standing out. I just don't like fake people. I hate fake people. And it's very easy for me to actually make out fake people just from the way they talk, or just from the first interaction. It's so easy for me to make out. I hate fake people. My other point is that your body is your temple. You have to take good care of your health, which is both your mind and your body, because mental and physical health are the most valuable assets to life, because everything else is just a byproduct of the two. And that means you have to eat healthy, you have to stay fit, you have to keep your mind, you know, zen. And just, you know, people mistake this, like, eating healthy and staying fit is not just for you to look fly and sexy. It also prevents you from contracting a lot of diseases. So eating right and staying fit, not just for your body goals, but actually for your all well-being. Okay, the rest is just, you know, looking fly and looking sexy is just like bonus to staying fit and eating healthy, but the main purpose of that is just actually for your health. Don't overwork yourself or don't underwork yourself. Understand your body and listen to your body. If you feel like eating carbs, do it. If you feel like, you know, eating carrots and broccoli, do that. But just listen to your body and, you know, take care of yourself. Pay attention to your body. So my other point is always have a safe haven, whether it's a thing or a place or an activity that you do whenever you feel that life has become so overwhelming. So if you wanna have a glass of wine, okay, have your glass of wine. If you wanna go for a walk, if you wanna have a long bath, or just even sitting down on the couch watching Netflix and eating ice cream, if that makes you happy, do that. If that helps you, like, just recollect your emotions and your feelings and just brings you back fresh, take it, because that's a breather for you and that's going to, like, boost your system and, you know, wakes you up. So whatever it is that brings you back to reality, do it and come back fresh. And yeah, we all go through that, so you're not alone in this. My other point is that don't be too much of an open book. I don't know how I'm going to explain this, but it's like, always have some mysteries in your life. Regardless if you have a person that you always share everything with, just leave some details to yourself and don't be too easily accessible to everyone. Let there be some mysteries of, like, people wondering what's happening with her, what's going on. Like, don't share too much. I feel like, I don't know, I hope you get the point, but it's like, don't be too easily accessible or too much open that everyone knows everything and you're so predictable. And don't be that, you know. Just keep some things to yourself and let there be some mystery in your life. Okay, so the other point is that trust the process. Everything that is happening in your life, whether it's good things or bad things, they are all happening for a reason. And don't focus too much on things that you cannot control, because you cannot control it. So don't stress out. I always ask myself in certain times, like, can I control it? Yes. So then I do something about it. Can I control it? No. So then I just forget about it. I don't even think so much about it. And that's how I have been able to manage how to cope with situations. And always use your passion to stay focused and motivated while still enjoying, you know, the process. So everything eventually works out. So stop being worried about life. My other point is that don't believe everything that you see, especially on social media, because no one is posting, like, their failures or their flaws. Everyone's posts their perfect life and everything, and you keep comparing yourself to them. No one is perfect in this world. Well, actually, perfection only exists in the human mind. It's not real. It never has been. It never will be real. Always live within your means and remember that every second spent wishing you had someone else's life is a second spent wasting your own life. So enjoy your life however it is. And my other point is that the past does not define your future, because a lot of people, including me, are usually held back by stuff that happened way, way back in the past. But you know what? The past is the past. If we cannot use it to become better versions of ourselves now or in the future, then we might as well just delete it, you know, unless it's a good memory that we can reflect on. Whatever happened, happened. We cannot change it. We cannot undo it. So we just have to live life and enjoy life. That it is okay to cry whenever you feel that you're so overwhelmed and you feel that everything is crashing down. If you have someone that you can talk to, then fine, talk to that person. But if you feel like you want to cry it out, and whenever you can, seek professional help, because depression is real and it's not easy. So whenever you can, seek professional help, or if you have someone that you can talk to, and just make it ease the burden. Because personally for me, I do cry, and whenever I cry, after crying I usually feel so much better. So crying is actually healthy. And whenever you can cry, it doesn't mean that you're weak, but it rather means that you're strong. That's it for this video, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. I hope you learned one or two things in regards to life. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and also because it's my birthday. So and drop me a comment down below. Let me know what you think of the points that I shared, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.